Okay, so today we're going to start a new series in Game Maker Studio 2. And what's different about this series is that we are going to use all drag and drop.
No programming.
So if you suck at programming, or you're looking for a faster way to make your games, drag and drop is for you. In this series, I'm going to show you how easy it is to make your own games using drag and drop. I'm also going to show you that you can make just about anything using drag and drop. So far I haven't found anything that you can make with coding that you can make with drag and drop. Okay guys, I'm gonna do this series. All I'm gonna ask you is to smack the like button down below. Alright, let's get started. You can download this working file from my website. There is a link down in the description below. Okay, so we're gonna start with the very basics. So let's delete this here. These are the sprites we're using. Okay, attack, magic, and run. Now this C stands for code. Okay, so this doesn't need to be visible. But we can leave it here just because. All right. Yeah, so we're gonna begin by displaying the player's health. We first have to make it. So let's double click on code. Let's add a new event. And we're gonna go create. So let's make a new variable. Let's call this, what can we call it? Let's call it red health. I'm gonna set it to 100. Now if you run this, you're gonna notice that variables are invisible. You can't see them, but that number is 100 already. Okay, so let's display it. Let's go to add event. We're gonna go to draw. And we're going to draw our health, or print it on the screen. Let's find text. Here it is. This is the caption. And let's draw our variable. Now the variable was called red health. If you type red, it will show up here. Now for the position, 200 on the X and maybe, I don't know, 50 on the Y. Let's run this. There's the health counter. Yeah, so we can display this relative to the position of our player. Okay, so you notice that this object is called red. This one is called green. Wow. So let's play the red X position. Red dot red X and red dot Y. And now it's displaying at the center of this sprite. Let me change the center of the sprite. Double click on the sprite. And there is our center there, our point of origin, middle center. And there you go. So let's add 50 to the Y position, or minus 50, I should say. There we go. Minus 50 on the X. Okay, so maybe a little higher. Let's see, minus 70. And that looks perfect there. We're gonna do the same thing for our green object. Let's do the same thing. I'm going to select the middle center. Fix the position. Okay, so back to code. Let's make a new variable. I'm just gonna copy this, paste it. This will be called green health. And as you've seen, these variables are invisible unless that you print them out. Just copy this, paste it. And simply call it red health. Now, our other object is called green, so we have to, let me just zoom in here so you can see what's going on. This will be green and green Y. All right, let's try it out. There you go. Now you don't have to have anything here, you can leave that blank. But let's give it a name. Let's call our a player. And this one here, let's call it enemy. Try it out. That looks good there. Okay. Okay, guys, if you're subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit the notification bell next to the subscribe button so you get a notification when the next video comes out. Okay, so that's part one. See you in the next video. Smack the like button. And if you got any questions, make sure you leave a comment.